Hello guys, welcome back to Chenda DIY. And today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet a floral square top. It is perfect for spring and summer. For this top, it can fit for size small and size medium. But I also showing you how to measuring and how to make the top more bigger in this video. Okay, now let's get started. First thing first, we are going to make the floral square. To begin, make a magic circle or magic ring. And next, for row 1, make single crochet into the circle. To make single crochet, insert the hook into the circle, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 2 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all 2 loops. Keep making single crochet into the circle until you got 8 stitches, then I will meet you back again. And after you got 8 stitches of single crochet, and next, we are going to pull the short string tight to close the circle. And then we are going to make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. To make slip stitch, continue insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. And next, for row 2, chain 4. For chain 4, we also count as a stitch. And after you got 4 chains, and next, we are going to make treble crochet 2 together into the same loop with chain 4. To make treble crochet, yarn over twice. Insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 4 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops. And yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. And now you have 2 loops on your hook. And then we are going to repeat the same thing into the same loop. And now you must have 3 stitches, include the chain 4 stitch. And with 3 loops on the hook, then yarn over and pull through all the loops. And this is count as your first petal. And next, chain 6. After you got 6 chain, then make treble crochet 3 together into the next stitch. You just repeat the same thing like the first petal by make 3 treble crochet into the same loop. And now you must have 3 stitches of treble crochet with 4 loops on the hook. Then yarn over and pull through all the loops. And this is count as your second petal. And for this chain 6, it is the corner of the square. And next, chain 3. After you got 3 chain, then we are going to make the parallel by make treble crochet 3 together into the next stitch. And after you have made the third petal, and next we are going to make the corner of the square by chain 6. And after you got 6 chain, then make treble crochet 3 together into the next stitch. So you just keep repeating this by make 1 petal and chain 3, and then 1 petal and chain 6 until you got 8 petals. Then we meet you back again. And after you reach the last petal, then we are going to chain 3. And next, count 4 chain and make slip stitch into the 5th chain, which is the first petal of the flower. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what the floral square looks like. You must have 8 petals. After you have made the first square, and next, I'm gonna show you how to make the second square and attach into the first square. To begin, you just make a magic circle and then make 8 single crochet into the circle. And after you got 8 single crochet, then make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. then we are going to chain 4 and make the first parallel by make treble crochet 2 together into the same stitch with chain 4. And after you have made the first parallel, then chain 3. And after you got 3 chain, and then we are going to make slip stitch into the corner of the first square. You can make slip stitch into any corner. And after you have made a slip stitch, then continue at 3 more chains. In total, you must have 6 chains. And after you have add 3 more chains, and then we are going to make second petal by make treble crochet 3 together into the same loop. And after you got the second petal, and then we are going to continue make slip stitch into the petal that next to the corner of the first square. As you can see, this is the petal of the flower, and we are going to make slip stitch into this loop of the petal. And after you have made slip stitch petal with petal, and then we are going to continue chain 3. And after you got 3 chains, then we are going to make the third petal. After you have made a petal, and then we are going to continue make slip stitch into the other side petal. And after you have made slip stitch petal with petal, and now we are reached the corner of the square. We are not going to make 6 chain, just chain 3. And after you got 3 chains, then make slip stitch into the corner of the first square. And after you have made a slip stitch, then continue add 3 more chains. In total, you must have 6 chains, and after you have add 3 more chains, and then we are going to continue make the petal. And this is what the half side of the square looks like. And next, you just continue at the other half side of the square by chain 3 and make the petal. And then chain 6 for the corner. And after you got 6 chain, then make another petal. Keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row. Then we meet you back again. And after you reach the last petal, then chain 3 and make slip stitch into the 5th chain, which is the first petal. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is how we attach the second square into the first square. As you can see, we always start working from corner to corner and make slip stitch petal with petal. And next, I'm gonna show you how to attach the third square. To start, attach the new square, you just make the circle with 8 single crochet and make the first petal with chain 3. And then we are going to continue make slip stitch into the corner of the other square. We are going to repeat the same thing like we have attached with the first square. After you reach the corner, then we are going to chain 3. And then make slip stitch into this loop, which is between the first square and the second square. And after you have made a slip stitch, then continue add 3 more chains. It is for the corner of the square. And next, we are going to continue make the rest petal of the flower until you reach the end of the row, like we did with the second square. Then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch, chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is how we attach the third square into the other square. And next, I'm gonna show you how to attach the fourth square. It should look like a diamond shape. Like I said, to start attach the new square, you have to make the circle with 8 single crochet and make the first petal with chain 3. And then we are going to continue make slip stitch into the corner of the other square. After you have made slip stitch, then chain 3. And after you have made 3 chain, then make another petal. And after you have made a petal, then make slip stitch with the other petal. After you have made slip stitch petal with petal and then chain 3 and make the other petal. And after you have made the third petal, then continue make slip stitch into the other petal. After you have made a slip stitch and now you reach the corner of the square, then chain 3 and make slip stitch into this loop between the second square and the third square. After you have made slip stitch, then chain 3. And next, make the fourth petal. After you have made the fourth petal, then continue make slip stitch into the other side petal of the square by skip this corner stitch which is the chain 3 stitch and make slip stitch into this petal that near the corner. After you have made slip stitch, then chain 3 and make the fifth petal. After you got the fifth petal, then make slip stitch with the other petal. After you have made slip stitch petal with petal and now we are reached the corner, then chain 3 and make slip stitch into the corner. After you have made slip stitch, then continue add 3 more chains. In total, you must have 6 chains. And next, we are going to continue make the rest petal until you reach the end of the row. Then we meet you back again. After you reach the last petal, then chain 3 and make slip stitch into the first petal. Chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is how we attach the fourth square into the other square. For the next square, you just use these three methods. Remember, you must place your square like a diamond shape, so you have to attach the other square corner with corner until you got the triangle shape, as you can see. For this triangle shape, it is for the front part of your top. So for my top, I made 4 rows of the square. Remember, for each row, you must have 1 square increase. So at the 4th row, I have 4 squares. As you can see, I already got 2 rows of the square. For the 3rd row, you just add 2 more square. And for the 4th row, you have to make 4 squares. For size extra small until size medium, you just make 4 rows of the square like mine. And for size large and size extra large, I recommend you to make 5 rows of the square. And this is how you're measuring the top on your body. You just place this triangle shape on your bust. By place it on the half side of your bust, the edge or the last row of the square must reach the middle part of your chest. And this is what the both sides of the triangle shape should look like on the bust. If you guys think that it's still small, you can add more rows of the square. And next, I'm gonna show you how to attach these both triangle shape together. To begin, start with the first petal with chain 3. And then continue my slip stitch into the corner of the other square, which is the first triangle of piece. And then add 3 more chains. And make the second petal. It is the same thing like we attach the 4th square. After you reach the corner, then chain 3 and make slip stitch both corners together by insert the hook into the corner of the square and then grab the second piece and we are going to continue insert the hook into the other corner and make slip stitch both corners together. After you have made slip stitch into both corners, then continue add 3 more chains and make another petal. Then make slip stitch petal with petal. Then chain 3 and make the other petal. Then make slip stitch into the other petal. And now we are reached the corner. Then chain 3 and make slip stitch into the corner of the square. After you have made slip stitch, then continue add 3 more chains and make the other petal. Keep making the rest petal until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. Thank you. After you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch, chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what it looks like. And for the next square, you just repeat the third method, which is how to attach the fourth square. Keep repeating this until you reach row 10. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what the front part of the top looks like. For row 5, I made 9 squares. If you guys want your top more bigger, you can add more squares. And for the measurement of this 9 square, it is equal 16 inches length. And for the next row, which is row 6, I make 8 squares. So you just keep repeating by make one row with 9 squares and one row with 8 squares until you reach row 10. And from row 5 until row 10, you must have 6 rows. And for you guys that want your top more longer, please add more rows of the square. And next, for the back part of the top, you can continue add more square from this front part. Or you can make it separate like mine. As you can see, this is the back part of my top. For this back part, I make 9 squares for the first row. It is equal 16 inches length. It's the same number like the front part. For you guys that make bigger size, you can add more squares to make your top more bigger. It's okay for the back part measurement bigger than the front part. And for the second row, I make 8 squares. Then you just alternate these two rows until you got 6 rows of the square. It is the same height and the same number like the front part. Remember, you must place both parts 9 square with 9 squares and 8 square with 8 squares as you can see in this video. So for the row that have 9 square must be the top part and the last row which is have 8 squares must be at the bottom of the top. And next, I'm gonna show you how to attach the center square between this both part. To begin, start with the first petal and you don't have to chain 3. After you got the first petal, and then continue make slip stitch into the square of the back part. So we are going to make slip stitch into the petal that next to the corner. After you have made slip stitch petal with petal and then chain 3. And make slip stitch into the corner. After you have made slip stitch, and then continue make slip stitch into the other corner of the square, which is the front part of the top. After you have made slip stitch both corners together, then chain 3. And next, make the second petal. Then make slip stitch with the other petal. And then chain 3 and make the third petal. And then make slip stitch into the other petal. After you have made slip stitch petal with petal and now you reach the corner, then chain 3 and make slip stitch into this loop that next to the corner. After you have made slip stitch, then chain 3 and make the fourth petal. Then continue make slip stitch into the other side petal. Then chain 3 and make the fifth petal. Then make slip stitch into the other side petal. Then chain 3 and make slip stitch into the corner. After you have made slip stitch into the third corner, and then we are going to continue make slip stitch into the other side corner of the square, which is the back part. As you can see, this is what it looks like. After you have made slip stitch both corners together, then chain 3 and make the 6th petal. And make slip stitch into the other side petal. Then chain 3 and make the 7th petal. And next, make slip stitch into the other side petal. Then chain 3 and make slip stitch into this loop which is next to the corner. After you have made slip stitch, then chain 3 and make the last petal, which is the 8th petal. Then make slip stitch into the other side petal. Then chain 3. Then continue make slip stitch into the stitch that we made slip stitch at the beginning of the square, which is the first petal of the flower. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what it looks like. For this method, you have to make slip stitch into every petal and into every corner around. And next, please repeat the same thing into the center square. Then I will meet you back again. After you have attached the center square, and next, we are going to attach this bottom square. But start with the first petal and chain 3. And then we are going to repeat the same thing like we attached the fourth square. And this is what it looks like after you have attached the bottom square. And next, please repeat the same thing to the other side. And this is how I weave in the remaining yarn. You can use darning needle to weave in or use the hook like mine. And next, I'm going to show you how to make the half shape of the square, which is the triangle shape. So for the full square, we have to make 8 single crochet. And for the half shape of the square, you just make 4 single crochet. And then you will got the 4 petals of the half square. To begin, after you got 4 single crochet into the circle, then pull the short string to close the circle, but you don't have to pull it tight, and then continue make 5 chains. After you got 5 chains, then turn your work, and we are going to working on the back side or the wrong side of the stitch. And next, continue make slip stitch into the other corner of the square. After you have made slip stitch, then chain 2. And next, make the petal into the loop that near chain 5. After you have made the first petal, then make slip stitch into the other petal. Then chain 3 and make the second petal. Then make slip stitch into the other side petal. Then chain 3. And make slip stitch into this loop that next to the corner. After you have made slip stitch, then add 3 more chains. And then make the third petal. And make slip stitch into the other side petal. Then chain 3 and make the fourth petal, which is the last petal. Then make slip stitch into the other side petal. And now we are reached the corner, then chain 2 and make a treble crochet into the same loop with the fourth petal. Please make it a little bit loose. After you have made a treble crochet, then continue make slip stitch into the corner of the square, which is the loop between corner with corner. And next, chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is how we attach the half shape of the square. And next, please repeat the same thing into the other square by start with 4 single crochet and then chain 5 and make slip stitch into the corner. And this is what it looks like after you have attached the half square. You just keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row. And repeat the same thing into the bottom part of the top. And this is what the top looks like after we have attached both parts together and the half shape of the square. And this is what the back part looks like. Next, we are going to make single crochet as the border around the top and make the strap. To begin, we are start working from the right side. Attach the yarn into the corner. Then chain one. And make single crochet into this corner space. You can use stitch marker to mark at this first single crochet stitch. It is easy to know where to make slip stitch at the end of the row. And next, make 5 single crochet into this strap ball space. After you have made 5 single crochet, then make single crochet into this circle. And then continue making single crochet into the next loop that near the circle. And next, make 5 single crochet into this chain 5 space. After you got 5 single crochet, and then make a single crochet into this corner space. And this is what it looks like. You just keep repeating this until you reach the front part, which is near the triangle shape. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the triangle shape, and next we are going to continue make 3 single crochet into the chain 3 space. And then make a single crochet into the parallel stitch. And for the middle space between the parallel, make 2 single crochet. And then make a single crochet into the next parallel. And next, make 3 single crochet into the chain 3 space. K, Keep repeating this until you reach the corner, which is the first row of the square, and then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the corner, then make a single crochet into it. After you have made a single crochet, and then continue at 64 chains. It is equal to 12 inches length. If you guys want your strap more longer, please add more chains. And after you got 64 chains, then we are going to attach this foundation chain into the back part of the top. For the back part of the top, you just count 3 squares and use stitch marker to mark at the 3rd square. Then count the same number to the other side. And next, make sure that your foundation chain doesn't twist. And then turn it into the back side and continue make slip stitch into the stitch that you mark. After you have made a slip stitch, then continue make slip stitch into the next 3 stitches. After you got 3 slip stitch, then we are going to make the bulk crochet. So as you can see, this is the right side or the front side of the foundation chains. When you flip it, and this is the wrong side or the back part of the chain, you can see the little bump. And next, to make the bulk crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into this little bump, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. Keep making the bulk crochet into the small bump of the chain. As you can see at the bottom part of the stitch, you can see the V shape is like at the top part of the stitch. So you just keep making the bulk crochet into the small bump of the chain until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. And next, we are going to continue make single crochet into this corner space. After you have made a single crochet, then make a single crochet into this parallel stitch. And then we are going to continue keep making single crochet like we did at the other side. keep making single crochet until you reach the corner, which is the top part of the triangle shape, and then we are going to make the strap by repeating the same thing like the first strap. And continue making single crochet into every space until you reach the stitch marker. And after you reach the stitch marker, then remove stitch marker and make slip stitch into the stitch that you mark. Then chain one and cut off the yarn. And next, we are going to make the front edge. To begin, attach the yarn into the stitch near the strap. And then chain 3. And next, make 2 double crochet into the same loop with chain 3. After you got 2 double crochet in the same loop, then skip 2 stitches and make slip stitch into the third stitch. And next, we are going to repeat the same thing by chain 3 and make 2 double crochet into the same loop with chain 3. And then skip 2 stitches and make slip stitch into the third stitch. Keep repeating this around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what the front edging looks like. And next, for the bottom part, you just make single crochet into every stitch around like we did at the back part. And after you have made single crochet, then make slip stitch and continue chain 2 and make double crochet into 8 stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Slip stitch, chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And now your floral square top is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Subscribe to my channel and don't forget to follow me on Instagram and Facebook page. Stay safe and stay healthy, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.